years ago here in that. I'm a storm fighter, storm chaser, and south, there was a big storm headed our way, and I was monitoring it for us. And there's probably three or four small tornadoes that spawned from that. I noticed they were hitting, the main thing they hit was fairgrounds. They had a concert going on at the time, and a high school football game. And they hit the football field, and the storm sirens were sounding, nobody's paying attention. And luckily, both places, someone was monitoring the weather, and at the football field, luckily the coach, who was going, had a body in the school just before the tornado hit. And the concert, it was the concert director that was monitoring the weather, and he got people away from the stage and from the shelter. And I've noticed that when that happened here, the same thing happened. We had a lot of storm sirens, but how many is it normal? I was looking at where we had places where people get courthouse, fairgrounds, school, and parks. So I started on a mission of my own. I talked to the city council, then we got permission to do this, and I started putting money for the first one up here. And I want to thank people who helped me with that when I get done with this. I've got one at the fairgrounds, the portable one that I've got from our stock, a $30,000 unit. Can be deployed to other towns and counties, cities, and springs where they have the festivals and all that stuff. I talked to Mr. Stubblefield at the park, and he's going to try to, in the next 2 or 3 years, get two installed, one in the kid park area and one at the other new golf course. These sirens are, I haven't had any luck with the school yet, but I'm still working on them. And these sirens are voice capable. You can use them for a PA system. So if there's a very storm sirens going off, people can, I set them off for winds approaching 70 miles an hour and a tornado warning. And you can use these PAs to tell people exactly what's going on. They're like, yes, hear a siren. Sure what's going on, maybe in the southern part of the county. You know. So this way you can get specific directions, like at high school, take shelter. We have a hardened area in the cafeteria. Please exit over the cafeteria and be safe. So that's I did all this. So basically, public safety, where the people gather in large numbers. Okay, people helped me do this. And it wasn't for Art Thompson, I probably would have done this. He was the very first person I talked to about this project. And he talked to him school through the first presentation of this, and he thought it was a dirty project, and he said he supported it. If he had turned me down, I probably wouldn't have been. So, anyways, let me tell you who got me with this. Community Bank, City Marshal, Cargill, MME, which is Mid-Missouri Energy, I'm off to them, Exchange Bank, Skip Hospital, and McDonald's. And I was going to demonstrate all of the sirens capabilities. But it turns out that the circuit court is in session today. I understand you can't hear this inside the courthouse, but they didn't want to take that chance. So what I'm going to do is have Mark, because he's the first one to help me get set this thing off, and we're going to do the national anthem. From what I understand, it sounds really good. It's going to swing right out on the outside of the square. So if we step outside, we'll do this. Appreciate everybody having fun.
All you gotta do is hold it until it goes. Thank you.